there are improvement works ahead, so this train will terminate at the next station.
Fake news, man. Fake news.
I'm so sick.
KK, how about that?
Are you a Muslim?
He should have been slapped as a child. He's a spoiled little Greek rat who's probably been treated like a prince.
I'm not a clown, but I earned everything I've got.
You also had people that were very fine people on both sides.
Oh, no, thank you. Unless it's,
just a donut.
Everything keto-free.
What's keto-free donuts?
It would probably be, fathead dough, most likely, which is made out of mozzarella.
A what?
No, it'd be almond flour. I'll make donuts. Wow.
Because I just looked at him. I literally just looked up at him as soon as you said almond flavor. I just looked at him.
Flour? Almond flour.
How do you make almond flour?
You buy it.
No, but like, I mean, what are the components of almond flour? This is honest to God question. I've got no idea.
I think it's just ground.
It's what, they ground almond into a powder?
Pretty much, yeah.
And then what?
It's a lot more sensitive than wheat, so it's harder to use it like as a replacement for wheat. Like, so we have almond flour and coconut flour.
Yeah.
Coconut flour is really absorbent, like it will suck in every juice known to man, and it's really hard to actually like bake with it.
So what's the point of it?
It's fluffy, so you can mix the two together.
Flavoring.
You can use like majority almond flour and then like get a little bit of coconut just for the fluffiness. Mix it up.
When you say
You got the micro in front of you, man.
You know,
you said you don't want me talking to old lady.
No, I don't want you like going.
That's
what I'm doing.
It's picking up every smack on that fucking
first
lip.
Of all, never talk with your mouth full.
Well, that's why I was trying
to. Okay, but you're still trying to get a question out to the man. Be like, you know what I'm picturing? This is his fault as well. Do you remember the, do you remember the Simpson episode where it's Bart versus Lisa, the hockey one?
Yeah.
And then, now, Homer, don't you eat this pie.
Okay, bye. I'll make a deal with you. I'm going to be biting air like this.
This guy would always do it. And then when he's actually chewing, out of hell with it. And he's like chewing. He's just got the big blueberry shit on his face.
Yeah.
That's him literally now with his burger.
When you say almond flour, you mean almond meal?
No, almond flour. Almond meal is different.
Okay.
I'm not sure what the difference is. So almond meal, almond flour, apparently almond flour is blanched and almond meal is not.
Okay.
I don't think that's any difference. I use blanched.
And is it, you notice any difference? Is it lighter or heavier or?
The only thing they say is that the almond skin blocks some kind of vitamin from absorbing in your body.
Okay.
So if the more you eat, the more you eat with the skin on,
yeah.
Supposedly just kind of it makes it no point for you to take the vitamin in or whatever. So I don't know. I can't remember exactly what it is. Something like that.
Okay.
Blocks something.
All right. Two things. One. Sorry, go.
No, it's all
right. No, go ahead.
One. Okay. I finally saw your almond milk. Because I was doing some shopping before.
Because
I had to buy the coffee and all that.
Yeah.
And I was just looking for some like little single serving coffee thing. Milk
sachets
or packets or whatever. But I didn't have them there. You probably got to go to Costco or something.
Yeah.
And then I was in the milk aisle and I saw the almond milk, which I never noticed before ever in my life. And I was just like, is there only just the one brand or is there a few brands?
Is it a white and green bottle?
No, it was yellow. Soy, what was it? Not soy, it was called,
soybean or something.
It's not soy.
No.
But it was almond, it wasn't soy.
Yeah, no, I'm very particular with my almond milk.
I would think so.
I only buy two types. One's from Costco, they just recently started, and it's
Bonsoy, it's called Bonsoy.
No, I don't touch that shit.
Okay.
You know, do you know one reason why I don't like the idea of soy milk taking over?
Because
It's like that whole 1984 thing, Soylent Green. Like, one day they're all going to be having us on Soylent Green.
Yeah.
Like, not actual food, but we'll just be eating Soylent Green. That's what it is.
Yeah. Look, I avoid soy purely because I personally get inflamed a lot. Like, that's just how I am. I've got a really shit immune system. And I think I told you guys last time.
Aren't there things that you can do to strengthen your immune system?
Eat nutrients?
You eat different foods, yeah.
So, in other words, Andy's diet is shit.
Well, I mean,
says the guy Macca's cup in front of him.
This is the first time I've had Macca's in over a month. That for me is like a grand.
I haven't had Macca's since July 2003.
And how are you feeling?
Better than ever.
It's good.
Legit, you haven't touched Macca's since then?
I think I've had maybe a McFlurry or something in that time.
That's pretty
maybe
good.
Maybe once.
Enough. That's pretty good.
Maybe once.
So what's your go-to fast food?
Honestly, other than like a random pizza or something, which 7 times out of 10 I usually make myself anyway.
Yeah.
Only time I really have fast food is when I'm hungover, which is not often. Mm. All right. Like, as in, like, I've had a big night on the booze.
You're going to say kebab, aren't you?
No.
Okay.
See, that's the thing. Kebabs aren't necessarily fast food. You can go to a restaurant and order a kebab.
Yeah.
You know, like a Turkish mix or a Dana mix or something.
Yeah.
So, unless you go to a greasy van, like, you know. But still, I would rather put a greasy kebab van over Macca's any day of the week.
Fair enough.
As far as nutrients.
Well, I mean, it's like
man, greasy, I don't consider any nutrients in any takeaway food.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not going there for that. I'm going there just because I have something quick.
Even sustenance, man. You go to Macca's, it'll go through you in 20 minutes. Get a kebab. Look at his face. His face is worried. The crap is just there, man.
Okay. All right. Second door on your left.
How long are we going for today?
We're going for a record, aren't we?
Says me. I've got a lot to talk about today. Seriously. I've got a lot to get off my chest.
Can you imagine we just turn and look at him in 20 minutes time? He's just sweating
the beads. His pipe little got all quiet all of a
what
sudden.
What time is it?
Meanwhile, in 1987, when I came back from Bacchus Marsh, you know what I mean? Haven't even hit the 90s yet. John's vein is just
wait,
like,
wait until we get to 88.
No, seriously. The only go-to fast food I have is when I'm hungover, and that's the KFC Twister plain with just a Powerade. That's purely to recover because I know that will help me recover. I've talked about it on this podcast at length.
Okay.
All right.
Pepper mayo.
What's pepper mayo?
It's the one they use in the Twister, the sauce.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's what it is.
Mm. That's what defines it.
That's what makes me eat that Twister.
Oh, it's
I'm
crazy.
I'm eating that just for that sauce.
Mm. They sell that at Aldi, I think.
Do they?
Yeah.
I've asked.
They sell a Nando's one at Aldi.
It's been a long time, but I asked KFC ages ago when I used to be obsessed with them, can I have a tub of it so I can dip my chips in? And they will not sell
it. Why would they give you a tub of sauce?
Why not?
Because they're 11 secret herbs and spices are under lock and key. There's like 3 people on the
planet. That got out.
No.
That has gotten out.
Didn't get out. They just analysed the ingredients.
No, there was I remember like a year or two ago, there was a woman who found it.
A WikiLeaks,
yeah. That was at the very bottom of the list after all the American government secrets.
It's like...
Well, he was a colonel. He was a colonel, so it could be military secrets.
But I'm pretty sure
it started as military supplies.
And the colonel and... I told you, man, he dead. The colonel.
I'm pretty sure it's on the website now because they can't, you have to.
You can't. Yeah.
You have to show.
It. I'm sussing this out.
I'm sure.
Seriously.
Type in KFC nutritional information. Go to it straight
no,
there.
No, but they don't. Secret herbs and spices. Hang on.
You don't have to look it up.
No, that's what I'm looking up.
Just go to their nutritional facts.
Shut up.
And they'll list ingredients because they have to.
Yeah.
We live in a day and age where they can't lie about it.
Yeah, you can't hide stuff like that anymore. Yeah.
You can.
No.
You can't. Not if you're a company like that.
Well, in Australia, you can't. No. If you're in Australia, you have to list everything that's in your food on the back of the bottle or whatever.
I'm so convinced that I looked it up and I found all the herbs and spices on their ingredient list that I replicated it with almond flour. I'm pretty sure I remember doing this.
Has it been revealed? No, I'm actually looking this up. Hang on.
Okay, you do that.
KFC recipe reveal. Tribune shown family scrapbook.
No. Oh.
Dude, it's still a secret. You don't have to list all the herbs and spices. Nutritional value is not herbs and spices, man.
No, the ingredient list is listed there because people have allergies.
Okay, secret herbs and spices, ingredient list. Oh, that shapes. That shapes balls, man.
Edit that one out. I just pictured when you were unscrewing your bottle cap.
Yes. Yeah, makes it nice.
Wait.
There you go. Hang on. KFC original recipe. The KFC original recipe is a secret mix of ingredients that fast food restaurant KFC chain have used to produce fried chicken. You know, like, I'm scrolling down the list of history shit, and the first word that I saw was moist.
Moist.
No, I'm serious.
It's nothing like a little bit of moist thigh.
Sanders' original recipe of 11 herbs and spices, one of the most famous trade secrets in the catering industry.
blah, blah, blah. Cigarettes were considered successful because everybody wants in on the secret. This recipe is not patented because patents are published in detail and come with an expiration date. So, yeah.
I'll take a guess right now. Salt. Pepper.
Black pepper.
Sugar.
White pepper.
Black pepper. Hang on, hang on, hang on.
There is white pepper. Someone did figure that out.
Wait a second. I'll tell you
peppercorns.
Now.
MSG.
Can you stop?
Yeast extract.
Yeast extract.
Yeah, which is sugar.
Okay.
Your favorite word of the dictionary.
He's just got that.
I found out so many different words people, like, that companies use for sugar. It's ridiculous.
He's got on speed, though.
Glucose.
Glucose.
Yeah, well, I don't think they actually use glucose.
Pesto benzene weight 37.5V.
Yeah.
Okay, no. Yeah. Okay. It's well attested. US Greek Creative Secret Blend, blah, blah, blah. All these shits. A lot of people have tried to, you know, create the closest thing to it. In August 2016, the Chicago Tribune reported that Joe Lettington of Kentucky, a nephew by marriage of Colonel Sanders, had claimed to have found a copy of the original KFC fried chicken recipe on a handwritten piece of paper in an envelope in a scrapbook. The Tribune staff has conducted a cooking test of this recipe, which took several attempts to get right. They had to determine whether the T's meant tablespoons or teaspoons. After some trial and error, they decided the chicken should be soaked in buttermilk, coated once in the breading mixture, then fried in oil at 350 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 177 Celsius, in a pressure fryer until golden brown. As a pressure fryer was too big, a deep fryer was used alternatively to substitute the pressure fryer. They also claimed that with the addition of MSG as a flavor enhancer, they could produce fried chicken which tasted indistinguishable from fried chicken they purchased at KFC. So this is what the recipe says that they found.
Yeah?
And this is the nephew by marriage of the colonel himself.
Paprika.
Can you let me just talk?
Isn't it better if we guess, though?
Yeah. All right, okay. No, I'll tell you what. Go guess. I'll tell you, there's 11 spices, right? And you mix it with 2 cups of white flour. All right? So let's go.
Salt.
Done. The end. His secret recipe, salt and MSG.
Black pepper, white pepper.
Okay, hang on. Yeah, keep going.
Oregano.
Mm-hmm.
Paprika. MSG. Paprika.
Well, MSG...
isn't a herb.
They added it just to as a flavor enhancer.
So does that count or not?
No.
Oh, so it's not part of the...
It's not in the original recipe, no.
Oh, okay. Let me recheck that.
I'll be honest. This recipe is pretty standard.
Like, yeah, that's what I assumed. Cumin?
Keep going. I'm not correcting you until you're done.
Oh, okay.
Cayenne? No, cayenne can't be there. That's spicy.
Might be in there.
Chinese five spice.
Oh, I think that's too strong for
I've worked for over 5 years to get this podcast up to a respectable standard. Finally get us some new digs. Finally get the equipment working. Everything's like Mickey Mouse. We're playing guessing games on the 11 herbs and spices.
Hey, these are the questions people want to know.
People want to make KFC at home. They want to pull out like three liters of oil.
People can figure
out. And start frying.
It burns.
You know what?
Continue with your recipe. Okay.
Just that stuff like that.
What else we got? Give me something.
I should write these down as you
said. Yeah, because I'm forgetting them as we go.
Why am I writing them down? I've got a computer in front of me. Jesus. Okay, notepad. Technology. Well, notepad, man. Usually...
So you said oregano.
So oregano, hang salt, on. Pepper, black pepper, white pepper.
Peppercorn.
Hang on. Oregano.
Drinking peppercorn? It's the same.
I think falling into black pepper.
Black pepper.
Can you just calm down, people?
Hang garlic on. Salt.
Oregano. Hang on.
I think powder.
Cumin.
Garlic powder.
Garlic powder, onion
white
powder.
Pepper, black pepper. Hang on, what'd you say? Oregano, cumin, white pepper, black pepper.
Salt.
Salt.
garlic
powder.
How many was that? We're at six. Okay. Was that six without garlic powder? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're missing one.
You got 11 herbs and spices.
Paprika.
Then. Paprika. Okay.
Onion powder.
Okay.
Should have put numbers next to them so we know how many.
Can you just relax, man?
I'm trying to think what's in my spice pan.
And a tumbleweed just goes past.
Did you say oregano? Oh, no, you did say oregano. Time?
No, we don't have any time. Oh, you mean time. Ha ha. Ba-dum-ts. There you go. Time?
Look at his face. Look at his face.
Keep going.
I reckon they use... two different paprikas. I reckon they use smoked and mild.
Possibly.
Well,
Andrew there with the distinction. Some smoked paprika as well. And that's mild.
How, yes. How many are we at?
We are at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. One more. Come on, mate.
Celery powder.
Celery
yes.
powder?
Yes.
Yeah.
Why is that?
It's like
I don't even know what celery powder is. I've never used it.
It's the secret ingredient that also helps stabilize a lot of foods.
Really?
Yeah.
Like, seriously?
Mm. Celery in general is a preserver of foods. People use, like, celery extract and stuff like that to preserve naturally foods. It's got, like, protective things to it.
I had no idea.
Mm. Like, when you buy sausages, yeah. instead of people using nitrates and shit, yeah. people will use celery extract or celery powder.
That is, I swear to God.
I know, it's interesting, man. Yeah.
Mm. Okay.
Celery is, like, super strong
yeah.
against right. disease.
Number one, salt.
Hey! We got one!
Number two, thyme.
Oh, good, yeah.
Actually, I'll tell you what. I'll run them down with the ones that you haven't got as last, okay?
Okay.
Okay? So, thyme, oregano, yeah? Black pepper.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
White pepper.
Oh, baby.
You got a paprika in there.
Mm-hmm. Just one?
Yeah, just one.
Okay.
Okay? And you've got garlic salt.
So you've said garlic powder? Well, salt?
It was garlic salt. He said salt, to be fair.
Okay, well, garlic, there's an element of garlic in there,
yep.
so I'll give you that.
Yeah.
You've also got celery salt.
Okay, it was
okay, sick. So you're there.
Fuck, there's a lot of salt. I'm hearing a lot of salt.
That's starting to worry me a lot. Americans, man.
From the south.
My heart's starting to stop.
I had a piece of chicken before I came.
My heart just stopped.
There it goes.
That's, right. That's actually scary to know that they're not even using the powders. They're using the salted versions of all these things.
What's the difference between salt and powder?
The powder's purely ground, like, garlic, but the salt
with salt extracted from it, like as in.
Well, they add the salt and then they mix it in to give it.
Do you reckon that's what it is? I thought they would like create the powder or whatever, and then like dehydrate it, so then you like left with the salt. You
know, no. Apparently, they add salt to the powder just to give it, so you don't have to use salt and separate to it. Yeah.
All right. Okay. So these are the ones you haven't got, right? What I'm seeing off the list, cumin is not there, as in it's not a part of the ingredients.
Okay. Turmeric.
Do you even say turmeric? You didn't say turmeric.
No, I'm thinking. Well, I was going to replace it for cumin.
Nah, turmeric isn't there.
Okay.
Also, onion powder is not there.
If turmeric was on there, people would be claiming it was an anti-inflammatory. They'd be eating it all the time.
That's true. That is true.
Yeah, no, like 0.1.
I don't know why I'm swelling up, but this turmeric is supposed to be anti-inflammatory.
they just absorbed like a liter of bloody oil.
And washed it down with like a Mountain Dew.
I mean, canola.
Yeah.
They use three types of oil to cook it.
Okay, but yeah, the rest of the list
do
is garbage.
No, I'm just saying that's the other three herbs. It's probably like I don't know.
So basically,
pumpkin oil.
Oh yeah,
canola oil.
So you got rid
olive
of,
oil.
So cumin's not there. Onion powder's not there, and what was the other one? Something else isn't there. Oh, no. Those are the only two.
Okay.
Yeah. You've got two forms of paprika. That's where you stuffed up. So, there's three that you haven't got right. The three that you haven't got right, tablespoon of dry mustard.
Ooh, wow. Okay.
Tablespoon of ground ginger.
They use ginger?
Yeah. And a half a tablespoon of basil.
Basil.
I don't get the basil, the ginger, or the mustard in any of this.
I could understand mustard. I could understand mustard, but not the other two.
Would you assume that's ground basil or fresh basil?
It would have to be ground.
Same? Yeah, it would have to. Yeah, I don't know.
There's no way it's.
Well, this is what they say, yeah? While Lidington expressed uncertainty that the recipe was the original recipe, he had a hand in mixing the original recipe for Colonel Sanders as a young boy and recalled that white pepper was a principal ingredient.
Mm-hmm. I knew that one. That's why. I went off on it.
What's the difference between white pepper? I've got white pepper, but I don't remember the actual difference.
So in terms of taste, it's pretty much the same, but it's the consistency of the color. So like, you get little tiny speckles on your chicken of black, but if they add all pepper, black pepper, the whole thing's just going to be look like shit. So the white pepper is purely there just to color, like in terms of color, you can't see it. You just don't know what's there.
Just to change the ratio, yeah.
Because we use both. A lot of Asian cooking uses white, and I've never tasted the difference. It's very powdery.
Yeah, it's powdery. I felt that.
White pepper, yeah.
It's less coarse.
Yeah, super, super powdery. But that's it. That's the only difference.
Hmm. Okay. Hmm. I was going to ask you, why are you watching sumo fucking championships?
I don't know, man.
I just feel like it's a real stoner thing to do.
I don't know. You don't smoke, so...
No, like, I don't know. I just popped up on my thing, on my phone. It's popped up saying, like, NHK, which is a Japanese news channel.
Do you know what I'm thinking of?
Yeah.
All the old video games and, like, all the old anime movies and stuff, they always have, like, NHK,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
banners.
Yeah, yeah, they do.
That's,
yeah,
what, that's, like, super vintage, like, yeah, Akira clip or something.
And I just caught my eye, and I was like, ah, I never got to watch it when I was in Japan, so I'll watch it now, and it was boring as hell. Like, these guys consume
thousands, you know, of years of history.
Nah, I'd rather scratch myself instead. Look, it's too boring.
I thought there was, like, multiple rounds where they're just going at each other and, you know, like, it lasts a good, like, minute or something.
A sumo Royal Rumble.
Yeah, yeah, throw him out of the ring. No, it's it was like each round was like 5 seconds of,
yeah,
like,
very short, aren't they?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then one guy goes down, the earthquake happens, and then that's it. That's the next match.
Oh, don't they have, like, three rounds in one match? No. So, first one down, and that's,
yeah,
it.
Yeah, first one down, you're gone. So, like, then you go back to eating 3,000 fucking calories a day for the rest of your life.
Oh.
It is. I was like, give me. I want to be motivated. I want to get, like, some kind of emotional attachment to one of these wrestlers, and I just can't do it. Because it's
next, too quick.
Next. All right, calm down.
Well, the entry and the exit would take 10 years. That's probably why it's quick. I don't know. But then again, if they set up a ramp, the exit would be quick. They just roll down as they get pushed out.
On a wheelchair or something.
Yeah.
Can you imagine that? Actually, that isn't as far gone as you think.
What?
Think about it, man. Think about how many industries have been corporatized, whitewashed, just taken the piss off, turned into absolute ass. Dude, best example, and it's related, Australian Ninja Warrior.
Oh, yeah.
How is that related? How in any universe is that related? I'm sorry, I have to bring that up.
No, I brought it up, well, like 3 years ago,
yeah,
like on this podcast. Yeah. We were talking about, I said, the fact that they use the term ninja
in
this stupid, like,
yeah, yeah.
You know, CrossFit gauntlet thing.
Mm.
The fact that they're using the word to market, and like the ninja, like a ninja itself, I mean, you guys know, has got historic reference. Mm. You know, it's got depth. It's sacred. You know what I mean? Secret society.
And there's very few left.
Yeah, exactly. It's a dying art, right? And then they used corporatism and, you know, capitalism to just trade on that name and turn it into a fun, family-friendly fucking, you know what I mean?
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Think about sumo wrestling.
I don't think they could do it with that. It'd be very, very, very hard.
Hear me out. Hear me out.
Mm-hmm.
All right. They took something as sacred as Playboy and Penthouse, and now we've got, you know, Love Island, where they literally...
Dan Bilzerian or whatever.
Dan Bilzerian's a gun, man. He's a legend. I had to explain to someone the other day who Dan Bilzerian was. It's like, who is he? Oh, he popped up in a movie I was watching. The Equalizer.
Did he? Is he in that?
What the... Dan Bilzerian's in it. Well, think about it. Dan, he fits it, man. He looks like a Soviet-looking dude.
Terrorist, yeah.
He's a big unit.
Mm.
He knows how to handle guns.
Mm.
And, he's a massive guy as well. He's in The Equalizer. He's an extra.
That's funny.
Yeah, he gets killed.
Good.
But, yeah, I had to explain who Dan Bilzerian was. It's a pretty man. I go, well, he was a venture capitalist. His father was a venture capitalist. And then he had, like, two heart attacks before the age of 32 and then became a poker player. And, now he just travels the world banging birds and testing out guns in main deserts. Like, literally, man, I had to explain to my old man, like, years ago, like, Dan Bilzerian. He's like, who's Dan Bilzerian? So I showed him, like, Dan Bilzerian's Instagram page. He's like, so how do we get to that guy's life? That's what the old man said. Anyway, but think about it, yeah? They've capitalized and corporatized everything. You're telling me one day the sumo wrestling's not going to go the way of that?
It'd like, be with, very...
With corporate backing?
Look, the thing, it possibly might already have it. It's just they don't emblazon themselves with it. Because, I mean, unless they tell them to start wearing a jersey.
Well, I was going to say, the only thing you could do is put your sponsorship on their underwear.
Yeah, on the waistband. Yeah. A bit like a 10XL.
With like a Subway jumper.
Subway.
I'm serious, man.
No, but it's very steeped in tradition. And like even the referee is very still dressed up in that old school style.
Even the people watching, if you watch the crowd, they're also dressed in old school kimonos.
Yeah.
You're fine.
they're coming out of the news of Yokozuna. I think it's sponsored by Subway Eat Fresh.
Seriously, man. You get like a Vince McMahon doing commentating.
Oh, man, Japanese.
What a slobber knocker.
That's it.
I mean, I don't even think they're refusing to even have a women's division, I think.
Yeah.
They won't even have a women's division.
Because it's too degrading or some shit, yeah.
Mm. What's too degrading? As having in to women. Be associated with women, like...
Overweight women.
There are female sumos, but yeah. I don't think there's like an official, like...
League
or division. I don't know female sumos.
Yeah, they're just not... Yeah, know, as popular, I guess.
They're just...
They don't get the spotlight.
So it's like the WNBA, the WAFL.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. Exactly, yeah.
But they have leagues. Yeah.
You hear that? Remember the whole stink that came out with the WNBA?
Yeah.
They're like the best ranking WNBA player.
Oh, don't get me started on that. Don't get me started.
I think it was actually one of the first episodes this guy came on.
Oh, really? Don't get me started.
I'm not trying to get you started. I'm just saying.
I do remember it.
Actually, oh, with the surfing. With the two kids.
Yeah. This guy was going off. Actually, did you know who popped up in the news? Do you remember the St. Kilda player, that bird?
Yeah.
Yeah, she popped up in the news. She's got some form of cancer.
The St. Kilda high school girl or whatever.
Yeah, remember her?
Oh, she got cancer, has she?
She's got cancer. Like, she had it and then it went away.
I thought she was just making a comeback to write a book or something.
No, she was writing a book. Well, she did.
Okay. Yeah.
But she's in the news again. But I just found it interesting. The same papers that were, like, shit-canning her 4 years ago, 10 years ago, whenever it was to come out saying, St. Kilda schoolgirl, tragic news, la, 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 la.
Mm.
Yeah, I'm a business owner. I'm a mother now. Like, and like, man, you absolutely, like, slammed this girl when she, like, popped up with Rick Nixon. They revealed her face when they shouldn't have. Remember there was that whole thing?
Yeah. That's right, yeah.
I don't know, man.
Well, the time's ripe now for...
Actually, speaking of... Yes.
It's the right time for that type of, you know...
It's moist.
It's the right time for that type of story.
Have you seen the thing with the silhouette challenge? I want your opinion.
I don't know anything about any challenges.
I only know about the blackout challenge.
What's the blackout challenge?
Is that the one where you hold your breath?
Yes.
As long as possible?
Yes.
What?
Yes.
Some chick, some 12-year-old just recently died trying to do it on TikTok.
How can you kill yourself doing that?
She tied a tie around the door or something.
Well, that's just called suicide by hanging.
Well, no, it was a blackout challenge. You know, she didn't mean to kill herself.
Well, what the fuck is wrong with you, man? Seriously?
This guy's lost.
He's gone.
He's actually
gone.
Headphones are off. Headphones are off.
I feel like I need to rewind it because I didn't even hear what was said.
I hit a nerve.
What did you say to him? I was trying to tee up this next video. What the hell were you
doing? Yeah, I think she might have tried it too as well.
oh my God. Are you for real, man? What did you just say?
We were talking about the blackout challenge and he said... He goes, how the hell do you even do that? And I said, well, she got a tie, tied it around her neck, and then she put it into the door. And he goes, this is called suicide.
And he goes, no, that's a blackout challenge.
Okay, I totally missed.
And the parents were like, oh, it's not our fault. It's TikTok and suing TikTok and ban TikTok from all countries.
Because their kid was too stupid to tie. How old was the kid?
12.
Yeah, nah.
That's the parents.
That's the parent. I don't think you're 100%. That impressionable at 12 where you can't monitor your kid.
Well, they apparently didn't see it for like 4 hours or something. They didn't find out until like 4 hours later.
Well, that is a silent death.
Can we not laugh about this poor kid's death? Seriously, this guy's going to punch his gun in the face. Seriously, you guys, we're talking about a death here. You're fucked.
That's disgusting, John.
I'm sorry.
Okay, these are
tears of sadness.
Well, yeah, they are. They're here. You're a fuckwit. Like, you actually are. This is the silhouette challenge.
Yes. I think I've seen this.
I'm okay with this so far.
And then it cuts to black and it shows them in, like, decked out and stuff, yeah? Yeah, I've seen it. Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Get naked.
That's the point.
Some do, some don't.
This is the point. The silhouette challenge is basically that, right? You take a video of her in like dumpy, frumpy clothing, you know, loose and trackies or whatever. Then it cuts to that track, and they're using a filter. It's a red rouge something filter. I can't remember what it's called on TikTok.
Like a red light district
style. Like a red light, yeah. And they're either getting naked or they're wearing their underwear, blah, blah, blah. But thanks to Reddit, they figured out a way to reverse the filter.
Oh, you're kidding.
So women are getting exposed because dudes, people are reversing the filters on these videos.
I mean, it's important to PSA this and just let us know what Reddit is this.
What thing? Thread? Yeah, we've got to tell people to stay away.
r/
That's bad. Isn't that in r/filter? r/red filter
Silhouette?
I'm serious. There was an actual thread. Hang on. Unfiltered silhouette challenge. TikTok's thoughts. So
I need to get on TikTok.
Oh, my God. Which website is that?
Oh, my God. It's disgusting. Where? Anyway. It's just funny. Like, I was reading comments about this shit, and I remember, like, I saw one random comment, you know, trust men to be totally disgusting and ruin everyone's fun, blah, blah, blah. It's like, well, hang on, man. I don't know. This is my
thought. Okay, let's listen to this. Let's listen to this.
When he's saying this, instantly it's controversial.
Yeah. Do you want us to get the sundresses back out and go back to the 50s, Dim?
I love how he's saying it, the most conservative out of all of us.
He's just going to come back later.
He's the one that's sticking up for Silhouette Challenge. Of all people, has he got any social media whatsoever?
The man who lost it at the suicide is now defending.
I told you he's the most cold-blooded.
The lovely, chunky black woman.
No. Honestly, I just thought, hang on, like, wait a second. Number one, it's not just men that are doing this. Women are just, you know, could easily do this as well.
Yeah, of course.
Because then you're shitting on an entire gender.
Yeah.
Not necessarily just shitting on it because, like, in a negative light because they're men, but you're also saying that women aren't adept to figuring this out.
I'm sure there's men doing it, right?
Yeah, of course. There are dudes doing it as well.
Huh.
Yeah. For me, it's sort of like, well, hang on, you put a video of yourself, a naked video of yourself on the internet, and now you're disappointed that people are actually seeing it?
Mm-hmm. That's like Paris Hilton years later. who leaked that video?
There's a man with a camera and a boom. Just ignore him.
There's a big microphone. just look into the microphone. Speak into the microphone. Yeah, okay, cool.
Yeah, cool. I never authorized. Thank Rick Solomon for that. What a legend. He cut a deal, man. Rick Solomon cut a deal with the same producers that did Pam and Tommy's art.
I was just about to bring that up too, yeah.
Yeah. Dude, those were videos. They were like commissioned videos. I just didn't expect them to get leaked.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And once they're on the internet, they stay on the internet.
Do you reckon that was the first sort of viral
Pam and Tommy?
Yeah.
Homemade stuff.
Yeah.
I think so.
Probably.
As in for like viral, like everyone had it sort of thing.
I think it was definitely the first one I jerked off to.
You're an idiot.
Oh, home videos.
We were what, year 7, year 8?
We were in high school. It might have already been out a little while before.
I don't know. But yep, I reckon, honestly, that was the first one.
Yeah, I would think so. I can't remember anything
before. Anyway, going back to the silhouette thing. Who's at fault here? As in...
No one.
It's there.
There's no fault, is
it? It's not like these guys, or like whoever, like, you know, these culprits, right? It's not like they went to someone's house with a camcorder and sat in their bushes waiting for them to get a video.
Yeah.
This video is on the internet.
They've made it
open
to people, yeah.
They've put it out there.
Yeah, I mean...
Well, you think the creators of TikTok aren't just, like, getting all these unfiltered videos of naked chicks and be like, oh, very good.
Why do they have an accent?
Because they're Chinese.
Yeah.
TikTok's Chinese.
That's it. So, all the developers, all the programmers, everyone's Asian.
We've got a special room for that. I mean, look at the deep...
Deepfakes.
The deepfakes.
It's a room this size with like 20 little Chinese guys working, sleeping bag on the ground, bowls of rice on the table.
They share the bag. They get thrown like a new bag of Basmati every week.
Sustain yourself.
They fight for the sleeping bag. Meanwhile, TikTok's worth what? Do you know what I mean? Seriously?
I mean, with the deepfake videos, like, that's just, you know, videos of whoever, and people just putting celebrities' faces
exactly.
on them. Celebrities
are $50 billion.
Is that all?
And they've got programmers sharing it.
Jeff Bezos just dropped that.
He just resigned. Yeah, he's going to resign.
Finish up on TikTok.
So, with the deepfakes, it's celebrities' faces being put onto, you know...
Original movies.
Adult entertainment. And now I've lost my thought. Yeah, so the celebrities have lost it. The celebrities, like, that's going to be taken down. Just like now on Cyberpunk, did you hear about the mod where they had you could have sex with Keanu Reeves?
Yeah, yeah, they took it down.
And they took it down. What? They took it down because there was a mod that someone had made, and you could, I don't know anything about it, but all I just read was you could have sex with Keanu Reeves.
Outstanding.
I love his defense. I know you can have sex with him. I don't know anything about it.
I don't have the game.
I heard 8 inches. I don't know for
I'm not
sure.
Too sure.
And several positions available, but again, not too sure which ones are the best.
Not 100%. But that's been taken down because I don't know whether it's his likeness and they don't want any trouble with that.
Yeah, it's kind of strange.
Like, is there a legal defense to saying, well, this isn't the actual person, so therefore I could have
their face on
that?
I thought he was already naked in the game. Didn't you already see his dick in the game? I'm pretty sure.
I don't think so.
I'm almost certain.
Are you sure it's his? Like,
no, well, the character in the game.
It's a mesh, man.
I'm sure they're not like, Keanu, can you please just, you know, just...
just whip it out for us. They've got the little dots on there, like, you know, with the rest of the game.
We're going to have to use the Matrix.
3D modeling. Yeah, the green screen with the 3D modeling.
We're going to need more dots.
Keanu, take these green little cups and hold them over your little wee-wee there, buddy.
Yeah, I'm sure they're going
to like to get anatomically correct.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, so, but would there be a legal, like, case
What's
for that?
What's the legal precedence to that?
Well, celebrities are saying you're using my likeness, but it's a digit, like, can you, like, not copyright, but can you put, like, legal backing to your likeness and say that can't be used?
I guess they can put it in the contract. Like, no, like, in their terms of service when possibly, they make the game,
it has
right?
to be in the
service.
No, I'm talking about these deepfakes of the celebrities. In the game, I understand. I understand in the game.
So you're just saying on, like, you know, what's it called? Like, Pornhub or something?
And people have made deepfakes of, like, Gal Gadot or whoever. Like, other female, even male celebrities.
Technically, no, if they're not making money off it.
Yeah,
because, true. Like, you know, soccer players have licensing for soccer games.
Yeah, but the difference is the soccer player licensing goes through their manager,
the proper
agent.
Legal channels.
Yeah, dude, Hulk Hogan was one of the first to actually trademark his name.
Yeah.
Because WWF wouldn't let him use it on his way to WCW.
Yeah,
he couldn't use it. That's where Hollywood Hogan came from.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So, I don't know, like, is there, like, can you trademark your face so that way it can't be on a deepfake video?
No, it's still going
to
get on a deepfake.
Because people are still taking, like, apparently, because then there's people being forced.
I mean, look at the movements to stop the Pirate Bay and all this. Yeah. It doesn't matter.
No, it's like, I just found this out, like, all the, with anime, Sony's buying up all the, I don't know, did we talk about this? Buying up all the anime sites.
All the
Crunchyroll,
all the subscribers,
Anime Lab,
all the streaming services,
Funimation. I think they're buying them all up because they want to monopolize the industry.
Yeah.
So
it's like Disney taking over Fox.
Everything. And so, like, everything's now being forced, like, you know, to what do you call it? Like piracy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know? And they're getting all these a lot of the sites are being shut down by Sony, like a lot of these pirate sites.
Yeah. Okay, but see, now that's getting off track.
Yeah.
Back to the original issue at hand, the silhouette videos, right?
Oh, okay, yeah.
Here is you making a video of you, like, naked in your jocks, whatever, putting it on TikTok or, you know, Insta to get your... What's wrong?
Oh, the bottom was so disgusting.
Yeah.
It was all there.
All right, you're putting it on there. You're putting it out there to get attention, clearly. Like, it's not a...
Yep.
You're putting it out there to be noticed for whatever reason, right? Yeah. Clout, likes, whatever. Now people are finding a way to reverse the effect of it, of something you've put out there.
Yeah.
So then, is there a case?
No. I don't know.
No, I'd say no.
Because you could say, like, it's the silhouette. Then, like, they could be naked, but they're not showing their nudity. In the sense, like, they're just showing
but
the outline.
The information's still in that bit of footage.
The fact that you can reverse engineer it to show, that means that people
it's there.
Should... Yeah.
But that just means people have learned to manipulate it. It doesn't necessarily mean...
But it's not like a deepfake video where it's clearly false. This is... All they're doing is removing the filter.
Removing the actual filter.
Yeah, because whatever programmers did in TikTok to do it, they just basically slapped the filter
you could
over
maybe,
it, but the information's probably still
there's
there.
There's a backdoor into removing it, yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like a game with a serial code on it.
Yeah.
All you need to do is put in an encryptor or a
keychain. Well, that is illegal, though, isn't it?
Dude, speaking of
that, I mean,
what do you spent the last 96 hours doing, man? Getting my new computer up and running.
Silhouette challenge.
Well, as a valid solicitor, after watching 20 minutes of my cousin Vinny last night.
Nice.
It was. it could be said, like, you know, that the original content has been put up as is, and so by manipulating it, you're like playing with the original content.
But anything you put onto any social media or TikTok or Facebook, they own it, right? Like officially, they own.
Well, there's
content.
A lot of stuff.
They can reuse that shit, can't they?
Well, I've
yes,
yeah,
unprofessional.
That's an alarm. That's just a reminder.
Take your vitamins.
Don't forget the. Oh, damn. You beat me to it.
You're a pill.
Don't forget to take your multivitamins. For my dog's medication.
Oh, did you? Well, how's he going to get it?
Well, he won't. That's just a reminder that I've got to give a certain amount of tablets tonight.
Oh.
I don't know. I started laughing, man, because I actually screenshotted this one. This one came up, like, on, I don't know, some either news article or Insta or whatever. It just said, PS, public safety announcement for the Silhouette Challenge. And the tagline is PSA to all the queens. I hate the overuse of words like queens, kings, la, la, la.
Yeah, that's pretty fair.
Okay. But if you're a queen and you're on the Silhouette Challenge and now you need to be warned that you may be found nude because you're dancing.
Yeah.
Like, you're not a queen.
Well, I don't know much about TikTok. But I'm assuming people that are already putting this on, they're already probably butt naked anyway.
Most of the time.
Yeah, well, that's the thing, right? Mm. Like, yeah.
Or TikTok, Snap, all that.
At most case, you're probably just going to get people saying that you're like, these people are probably seeing themselves as victims, and they're probably just going to turn back on you and just say you're victim blaming.
I think they're just chasing money at the end of the day.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, I'm going to sue TikTok because they allow a backdoor into, that's what's going to happen. TikTok will probably pay out some people and be done with it.
No, they won't pay out anyone.
You don't think they'll pay anyone?
Nah. What I was going to say was,
is it banned in America?
This stuff
anyway?
Has come up.
No,
on
Trump tried to ban it.
Oh, he didn't?
Because the majority of Democrats are spreading like anti-Trump
through,
like,
TikTok.
Through TikTok, so it's like it's a Chinese.
So it didn't get banned.
Well, no,
he tried to.
The issue with TikTok was that it's they just don't like China. That's what it comes down to.
Yeah, yeah.
And so it's like, well, there's cases where it's come up where they have, like, you know how you got, like, how you're given permissions and stuff when you get your apps. There's been cases where it's come up as they're using it and it's like actually registering your
keystrokes
and stuff like that.
Yeah, yeah.
And they just didn't like that. Yeah, well, there's probably other stuff as well.
It was a couple of brands in particular, like Xiaomi or something.
I mean, you know, like Facebook and Google and all that are taking information, but they probably don't like the fact that it's a Chinese company doing the
WhatsApp's
same thing.
WhatsApp's apparently been done pretty hard at the moment as well.
Yeah.
Because they're apparently just like taking all of our conversations and sending them straight through to Facebook and then just doing whatever they want with them. So that's a bit concerning. A lot of people have dropped WhatsApp for that reason.
Yeah, people.
Yeah, I heard something.
I had a group of mates that were. Was it Telegram? Is that what it's called?
Mm.
Yeah. Telegram.
You're right.
I got something in my throat. I think the coffee. I might have had like a low quality grain or something.
You are so special. Seriously.
Telegram is the privatized social media thing.
You had a low quality granule of Aldi coffee in your throat,
stuck
and
in
it
there.
Made you wince.
Not wince, just.
I'm going to jump over this table and beat the shit out of you, I swear. I'm telling you, I never thought I'd ever see the day where you became so homogenized.
I'm a very sophisticated human being.
Just pasteurized to the shit house, man. Seriously? Louis Pasteur. Yeah. No, that's it.
Don't have to pasteurize that.
Okay. Telegram is that, right?
Mm.
What's the difference between Telegram and WhatsApp?
It's private.
As in what? Privately owned?
Telegram doesn't store information.
So then why would WhatsApp store information?
Well, because they want to sell it and use it. Same as Facebook. You know, because Facebook bought WhatsApp, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so they're doing exactly the same thing as what Facebook got done doing, which was storing our information and selling it off to companies so that can target ads.
Market
they're
research.
Literally taking, they've been caught taking the chat logs from WhatsApp, sending it through to Facebook for the advertising, and then targeting the advertising.
But it's not like
during the link.
These chats, it's not like they're being literally looked at by individuals in
rooms. Apparently so.
Isn't it just filters and it finds just spot words?
Possibly, but
it's both.
At the end of the day, those are private conversations.
I agree. I'm not, okay.
I don't know.
I'm just saying the idea of, like, again, 50 Chinese dudes in a tiny room with one sleeping bag, looking at, you know, it's my WhatsApp conversations.
It's not unheard of.
Mm.
It's real. It's a real. They do that.
There's on some of the. I've told you about that guy Tim Pool on YouTube, and he's got his own podcast as well. And he, you know, he's got interviews where he talks to people who used to work for Facebook and stuff like that. And they, you know, like they're actively going through people like different pages and looking for stuff to remove or stuff to, you know, to copy.
It's
on.
It's not all algorithms. Yeah,
yeah.
It's people.
Yeah, there are companies.
So should we get off WhatsApp and get on Telegram?
Technically, yes, but Telegram is also dangerous because it's like unmoderated sort of thing. It's a bit of a free for all.
So, what do you mean by unmoderated? What's bad about being unmoderated?
Because these guys that I used to play pool with a lot, they said to me, "Jump on Telegram," because I'm setting a group up. I said, "What the hell's Telegram?" This is like a year and a bit ago, and they said, "Yeah, it's secure, unlike WhatsApp." I'm like, "Okay, this was in the infancy when no one had Telegram."
Well, do you think people have the right to be able to talk to message each other without being moderated? Without the conversations being looked at?
I think anything that's free that you're not paying for, I would expect my things to be looked at. That's just how I feel. If I'm not paying for something, I expect someone to be looking at it.
But that's what people forget, man. Mm. Things like Google, things like Facebook, things like YouTube, every time they go down, people lose their absolute bananas saying, "My Facebook's not working, blah, blah, blah." It's like, what did you pay for Facebook?
Yeah.
Nothing.
Exactly. Mm. That frustrates me as well.
Like, relax.
Yeah.
You're not at a drive-thru at Macca's waiting for your meal.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? This isn't a service you're paying for. There is no commitment. There is... The only responsibility Facebook has is to not sell your shit or do anything like that.
Which they're already doing.
Anything malicious.
Well, yeah.
Look, your loyalty cards, Woolies, Coles, Flybys, your credit cards, your bank details, your... I don't know about PayPal. Your... What else? Facebook. Google, WhatsApp, probably Snapchat, TikTok, what else? I wouldn't say Reddit.
I don't know
Instagram.
What he's listing these off for, so I can't help.
Twitter.
So
that's all being...
I'll cut you short for a sec. Do you want to move your stand so it's low like this? See, like, ours is stretched out? So it's not intrusive.
It's not like a bicep that's...
No, I'm just saying. Like, see how I'm sitting? I'm literally stressed all
over. This
is
the dud one that Andy always has that always springs back up.
No, this one was doing it. I've stretched it out.
You're gonna come over here. All right.
No, is that better?
Closer.
No,
Clarice.
You have to move the mic a bit.
Hello, Clarice.
Hello, Clarice.
It's good to see you again.
All these companies, these are just some that I've listed off, they're all taking information and selling it.
Yeah. Of course they are. And so, I expect them to.
Yeah. That's what I'm getting. So don't think like,
Telegram.
Telegram. They say that, but eventually, if they want to make money, they're going to have to start selling stuff.
Yeah. Well, this is why, because they're not, that their need to make money is not as abundant as like Facebook and all the stuff.
They can't pay the bills where their servers are in Silicon Valley.
But that's what happens.
So they've got big hard drives. It's like, must go.
Well, look at YouTube. Look at YouTube, all right?
Yeah.
YouTube, in its infancy when it started, it was all about the individual
chocolate rain.
Oh, do you remember that?
Chocolate rain.
That's the infancy right there.
I'm just seeing the South Park episode.
No,
internet money. they were all about the individual the people, the personalities on YouTube.
Similar to what Twitch is now.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
But in time there was, as it became more popular and popular, they started introducing ads, all right? Because they're going to make money. Now, if you are considered to be advertiser-friendly, you just can't monetize your channel at all, okay? They've got a list of what is acceptable and what isn't, all right? Then, as they want to keep making more money, they start phasing out the stuff that was more acceptable in the past to now just making it very vanilla.
Yeah.
Because they want to make money. How they were 10, 20 years ago, or 20 years ago, man. Whatever it was. There was no money behind
it. You can't hit a video now without seeing an ad or two ads.
Or at least.
Like, it just does not happen. It's very rare to find some obscure video on YouTube and press play and not see an ad.
Yeah.
That's standard.
Yeah.
It's just like at the start, people might they might have good intentions.
Yeah.
In trying to, we're not going to sell your information, we're not going to do ads. But then it's not sustainable because they need to make money.
Yeah,
there's a channel that I on YouTube that I'm subscribed to. Just Asian Boss, you might know it.
Oh yeah. Oh, I saw the video. Yeah.
Okay, so that's been around for how many years? Six, 7 years.
Yeah, a while now.
And they don't do ads at all, I don't think.
Nope.
No ads whatsoever because they've got a private investor. Now, the investor...
There's two guys, right?
Two guys, I think.
And then the private investor, yeah.
Yeah, they've gone bankrupt. Not bankrupt, but they've lost a crap ton of money over the COVID. They can't sustain the money. So they announced that they'll probably be shutting down within a month or two.
Mm.
And this is a channel that just brings you Asian culture.
All Southeast styles of news. And it's like, it's unbiased for the most part. It's never been political, like to one side or anything like that. They're pretty good like that.
And, you know, they did that with no ads. So they chose not to make money via that way. Now it's not sustainable because the investor and, you know, who foresaw, you know, a global pandemic.
Yeah.
But, you know, now that means they'll probably shut shop in a couple months.
Yeah, but then again, if they just change their marketing a bit and actually get, like, you know, Kickstarter. I'm sure if they went and started a Kickstarter page.
Yeah, possibly. Open,
their thing is that, one of the guys who runs it is Korean and he's poured his funds, life savings into starting it.
Mm.
What was he before? Lawyer or something?
I think they were both lawyers.
Lawyers, yeah. So he's dumped all of them. They both dumped all of their money into it and they've never wanted to ask for money. That's why they're so hesitant to do the Kickstarter or
people
stuff like
drop
that.
Money on them no tomorrow. Yeah. It's a good channel.
I always thought about that with the podcast because people are like saying, do you make any money from it? I'm like, no, not yet.
Okay. Yeah.
Can you? I said, well, you know, you build up an audience, maybe get someone in, advertise something, you know what I mean? All that sort of shit. It's like, well, then why do you do it? I said, because it's fun.
Yeah.
I was thinking about it. I was like, well, what does it cost? Cost me off the top of my head, $6,000 to do it a year.
Yeah.
Just to have the studio.
That's assuming everything goes right.
Assuming everything goes right. I don't need to buy any new equipment. And that's outside of my time doing it.
Yeah.
Yeah. And now, I mean, with this place, I don't need to fuck around anymore. You know, it's pretty plug and play. So, you know, the idea is it's going to take, you know, say, 3-4 hours to record, another 3-4 hours to edit.
Yeah.
Right? So that's a day's work for free, basically, off my back.
Yeah.
So what's minimum wage? $25, $20 or whatever. Yeah, you're looking at, you know, $150 a week.
Yeah,
that I'm thinking. And then so I said, well, can you get anyone to back it? Like, why don't you start a Kickstarter or one of that? And I said, well, I need to promise them that I'm giving them something, and then there's the pressure of actually doing an episode,
and following up on it,
blah blah blah, delivering the goods. And then there's also the pressure of if I say something that offends any of these people, technically they've paid for me to do it.
Yeah.
So the recording is basically spent. The rule of thumb is your recording is owned by the person that pays for it.
Yeah.
So all the recordings I've done over the last, you know, 100-odd episodes.
Well, I would think that it would be from when you start taking payment, wouldn't it? Or would it be the whole?
But like, as in, okay, I've done how many episodes with you guys now? 10?
Yeah.
Maybe, yeah.
Yeah? I own those recordings.
Yeah.
Mm. So if I want to make a promo, you know, a reel, you know, if I want to put your voice is in a radio reel or a commercial. If I want to make a track and sample something stupid that we've said, I own that.
Yeah.
Mm. You can't come back and say, that's my voice. You owe me royalties for that song.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like, well, no. I paid for the recording. You never came down and said, you can only use... Like, you haven't signed a waiver. You haven't signed a contract.
Yep.
And that's just the breaks.
Yep.
What's wrong?
Give me a pen.
There's a pen right in front of you.
Oh, there is two.
I thought... What are you doing?
I'm just going to start writing out my contract.
Dude, two big Jewish dudes. Just stop walking in.
Stop right there. My client is signing nothing else.
Heisenberg and Heisenberg.
Literally.
My name is Josh Heisenberg, and this is Heisenberg.
Anyway, but yeah. So that was the thing for me. Like, no, you know what? I don't want anyone.
But you know what? You could look into that. I don't know if, yeah, by people contributing money to, if they did own anything of, like.
Not if you do it through, like, Patreon or, like, buy me a coffee or something like that.
Want to do one of those Al Pacino ads? You know?
This is good coffee.
No, you have no idea.
But you don't have to ask for backing. You go into, like, buy me a coffee or something and you say, oh, if you can afford to buy me a coffee, you do it that way because there's no direct. You're not giving me money for...
What's buy me a coffee?
It's basically the guy started it as a... Like, similar to Patreon, but it's not some... Because it sounds a bit better. It's like, I don't want your money. Just buy me a coffee. What's a coffee? $2.80, $3? All right, done. That's what you're doing for me. You're buying me a coffee for one day. So, if you want to donate, then donate me a coffee. which means that you don't really have like a legal obligation to link it to your business.
Mm.
And for them to say, hey, hang on a second, I'm investing in your business and your podcast, and you're saying this,
Is it tax-free?
I don't know. That's a good question. I'm not sure.
If it's tax-free, what's the site called? Buy Me a Coffee.
I think it's probably Buy Me a Coffee, yeah.
Seriously?
Or Tip Me a Coffee, something like that.
You guys fuck off. That's what I'm
Seriously. Before you leave me a coffee fee. $3
coffee.
2 months later, find out he's been doing a podcast every week. You haven't been called back.
Yeah, you're right. Loved by artists, YouTubers, without stitching together a bunch of apps like Patreon, MailChimp, and Donate Button.
Yeah.
Blah, 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 blah.
It just takes a lot of pressure off people, I think.
Okay, cool. Man, I think I should put that up.
Mm.
There's a mystery donor of $60,000. Like, the hell?
John comes out. So at the time I bought those coffees, I'm going to want some reimbursement now.
Speaking of reimbursements, Jeff Bezos has stepped down as CEO.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
That's insane.
He made his floppity jillion dollars.
His floppity floop.
His floppity jillion dollars?
Yeah.
You know what? Like, Jeff Bezos started Amazon in his garage.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I mean,
what was he selling? Books.
Mm.
Yeah. And he went from that to being like...
the richest man in the world.
That's it.
Because Americans don't know the word self-control, you know?
Yeah.
Buy local or something else. I don't want to leave my home, so I'm going to order it online.
Idiot. The richest man in the world. Like, that's it.
Well, I mean, it's...
king of the universe.
It is what it is. Just like, this is Andrew, leave a message.
You know, like, you're rich, Andrew. Leave a message.
Leave a message. What else is it? That's it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He is the richest man in the world. But having said that...
and you know what's scary? Like, it's accelerating how far... like, it just accelerates how fast he's just keeps getting that lead ahead of everyone else.
This he's not going to lose.
Yeah.
There will never be a game over, like, for Bezos until he dies.
Mm.
Even then, I reckon he'll probably figured out how to bring himself back to life.
There was a stat, like, a couple of years ago now that said that someone worked out that if he spent something like $10 million a day, it would still take him 360-something years to spend all his money.
How much money do we have to spend a day?
10 million or 10 million a day or every 2 days, something like that.
They've done on YouTube.
Some stupid number.
They've done on YouTube, I think it was, where they've compared within Minecraft, the blocks, you know, your crafting blocks, like the monetary value of different rich people in the world.
Yep.
And they've showed and then it's like, I don't know, like, here's a microphone.
There was Reinhardt.
Bill Gates. This and that. And they, you know, like so many gold blocks or whatever, and then they show Bezos or whatever, and it's just like an entire field. It's massive. It's like an entire, massive.
So he's got his own game.
He's got his own game, yeah.
Minecraft 2. Bezos edition.
His own, what's it called? Console, man. Forget the game. He's got his own console. I read the best thing to come out of that like whole thing was his wife. All the memes that came out after
the divorce,
split up.
Yeah.
It's like one of the richest women in the world, source of income, divorce.
Yeah. You know what I mean? I love how she actually, I don't know if you guys saw it, but she said something like, it's my money and I'm equal to it or something like that.
Yeah, because he set it up when they were still together and she supported him.
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, she's entitled to it, so.
Is she? Well,
I don't know, is she?
Bezos, mate, if you're listening, I love bald men and I'm into it. And,
well.
I'll take you for a ride for a day.
Well, Dimitri, as a qualified solicitor, after watching 20 minutes of My Cousin Vinny last night, I believe English common laws dictates that, you know, a married couple, two spouses married to each other, unless a prenup is signed, is entitled to half of one said monetary value.
You're such a fuckwit.
I don't mind. Hey,
you're like the Rudy Giuliani School of Law. He actually brought up My Cousin Vinny in the whole
trial. Did he?
He used that as a part of his defense.
Oh, man.
He's such a fucking...
Do you know what I don't understand? Why why people attack Bill Gates for the whole COVID thing where he's like trying to implant chips into vaccines and stuff, and they don't go after Bezos?
Because they're stupid.
Exactly. I was getting ready to say a whole thing, but he just summed that up perfectly. Because idiots are going to idiot.
Yeah, okay.
You know, like...
they don't know.
I mean...
dude, it's also 5G towers.
Yeah. Mm.
Like, I can't believe I'm back at 5G. It was one of the last things I spoke to with the Iraqi kids. Yeah? And it's like, 5G towers are not responsible for COVID.
No.
It's physically impossible. It's a radio frequency. Okay? You're fine with 2G, you were fine with 3G, you were fine with 4G.
You were happy about 4G. Everyone was excited for 4G.
Here's another version. And now they're trying to tear down towers. Like, that's going to make a difference.
Look, there's no denying that they have radiation. Sure.
And it's not going to cause COVID.
And the frequencies. No, but it's got nothing to do with COVID.
Yeah. No.
It's ridiculous.
And the vaccine.
People go into space and come back half blind and no one cares about that. It's like, oh, well, he didn't go into space. He probably stood next to the 5G tower.
There's people literally wanting to go to Mars, okay? And they don't realize that, you know, the bone decay of going into space. Okay?
The age, the bone, so the eyes.
Yeah. They go up looking like Shirley Temple. They come back looking like. What was the name of that?
Like a shriveled walnut.
What was the name of that Jewish comedian from America? She had all the plastic surgery. She died like.
Oh, Joan. Joan Rivers.
Joan Rivers. Oh, Joan Rivers. Yeah.
Shirley Temple, Joan Rivers.
Apparently, I think it's like a month in space is equivalent of like, I don't know how many years of bone decay.
Okay, let's have a look. Bone decay.
Bone mass or bone
in
decay.
Space.
You know, so the trip of just going there,
yeah,
okay. You would lose so much bone.
I know it does a lot on the bone and the eyes.
In my 2 minutes of being a microbiologist, thanks to me watching The Martian last night, in the microgravity environment of space, astronauts lose on average 1-2% of their bone mineral density every month. Just like muscles, if you don't use your bones, they will weaken. But proves all the dudes sitting at computers just like, their fingers are like rock solid. Everything else just withers away.
And then carpal tunnel.
Yeah. Bone loss occurs in the weightless environment of space because bones no longer have to support the body against gravity.
Mm.
Okay, well,
what about
sense.
The eyes? Because I know eyes deteriorate really fast too.
Okay, so eye decay in space.
Eyesight decline maybe?
I haven't heard anything
okay,
about eyes.
Here we go. Space travel messes up that finely tuned system due to the lack of posture-related pressure changes while living in microgravity. This increased the pressure on the back of the astronaut's eyeballs, causing them to flatten and leading to increased protrusion of the optic nerve.
Okay.
I did not know that.
That actually makes a lot of sense.
Just going back on that, you know, you got Bill Gates who spent probably the most money in human history.
Supporting.
On philanthropy.
Yeah.
Well,
you know.
He is.
Who's actually doing stuff to help, you know, people around the world. And then
especially
you've got,
in the poor.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Developing nations.
Yeah.
Sorry. Developing nations.
What is this? Hey, I'm poor. In a first world country.
Well, ask
hey,
Bill, for where's my money? I want my check, man. What's going on?
Bill, can you buy me a coffee, mate? Jump on the website.
Listen, Bill, it's $6,000 to do this podcast. We're up in Yasa.
Can you spot me for like 5 years? No. We don't have to worry about it.
5 years? I just take a check for 30 grand and disappear. See you later, dickheads. What about the podcast? What podcast?
What do you think of the new Kawasaki?
Come back with a $30,000 bike.
It's a mobile podcast now.
By myself. In a helmet with like a microphone.
Just commenting on everything you see as you drive past. Then you got a man who's like, quadrupled his net worth just within a 1 year period over COVID because everybody's been stuck at home and ordering online. This guy hasn't done, as far as I know.
Did you see Bezos in like a microbionic chamber, like not allowing any germs to come in? I've survived COVID.
Picture him as Mr. House from New Vegas, Fallout New Vegas.
Let me suss this out.
I just picture him as a villain. I swear one day he's going to come out in like this suit of armor. You know, he's going to be like, all right, I control the planet. And everyone's going to be like, what? What is this, Lex Luthor or something?
You know, is it Mr. Scorpion or Mr. Scorpio, whatever, from The Simpsons?
Hey, Scorpio.
Scorpio.
I quoted him today. Homer, who do you like better? Who do you hate more, France or Italy?
France.
No one ever says Italy.
nicest guy on the planet. Trying to take care of the world.
This guy.
Yeah.
Oh, didn't you describe Queen Elizabeth as this?
Yeah. But that's what I picture him as. Like, that's him there. Like, in the future, he'd have, like, his own...
just a pod.
Just an avatar on a screen.
Yeah.
And then you go in the back screen, like, the Wizard of Oz, and he's just, like, this...
decrepit, reptilian...
Husk of a person. What?
He's the voice of Anonymous.
Yeah, that's right.
I am Jeff Bezos. I do not forgive. I do not forget.
What do you reckon, honestly? Because, I mean, we don't know who... We don't know who Jeff... Can you cut? All right, well, they've lost it.
Leave a message.
Fuck off! Okay. We don't know who Jeff Bezos is, right? Like, I mean, we don't know him. We see he's...
No.
You rarely see, like, he's not like a celebrity where, you know, he's in the media.
Yeah.
You know, he's shooting hoops.
He's a pretty private person from what I think. Yeah. You heard
So, like, we don't actually know what he's like. What do you reckon he's like at around his family, like at barbecues?
He's the smuggest bastard out there, I reckon,
Just because of his bald face.
I don't know.
And his shirts. I feel like he is. Like, you don't get that vibe from Bill Gates because Bill Gates never wore anything pretentious.
What do you think?
Like, he's dressed in, you know, Target. Yeah.
He's a bit loose. Gates, like, seems a bit loose, laid-back sort of style.
Steve Jobs was definitely a smug sort of king of the universe sort of feel.
Fuck him.
But Bezos just looks like a cockhead. Like,
You reckon? Like, I don't know. What do you... I have no opinion. I don't know.
Like, you could be sitting at a barbecue, and, like, he knows Amazon.
Give me a drink. He's a 50.
You don't know if he's intelligent, like, on a broad scale. Like, he's got to be a smart guy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right? Well, yeah.
He's got to be a smart guy because he's an entrepreneur, okay? Like, what's the other? Musk,
yeah?
Elon Musk literally is Iron Man in real life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, we're waiting for him to build that suit and fly us away. But, like, Bezos looks like that guy. You'd be at a barbecue just talking opinion. Not even fact, just opinion. He says something which is completely inaccurate. And he's looking at you, just shut up, Jeff. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, he's your cousin. He just looks at you, just gives his grin. And you know he knows.
That guy just comes out of nowhere.
You know he knows that you know he has, like, a gold Ferrari parked outside. With a hovercraft, like, you know, and propeller. Like, he looks like that type of guy. He just went up and, like, coat hanger, like, one, just in the middle of the night.
I can just picture him, like, at a barbecue and just being like, Melinda, sunscreen. And then some chick just comes and just
slaps his head.
The cousin that gives him crap, and then just some guy just comes up, karate chops.
He's got just one person for every one job.
The way he's like, they just know. It's like,
there's like 4,000 people in the mansion just waiting for the click, and they all know which one.
Yeah, if that's one of these ones, four guys jump up. You know what I mean?
The clap reminds me of coming to America.
I was thinking the same thing.
Dude, my cousin, for some reason, last time I saw him, every 2 seconds, he was just going, wipers. That's coming out soon. Has it been streamed yet?
No, I haven't seen anything. You know what's...
No, I was going to say, it's not going to get released to cinema at all, is it? Not even Netflix.
What's weird is because I was looking up to see the date on it, and for some reason, I think it was doing like Poland or Bulgaria as its release country.
Because it's... Yeah, okay.
I don't know. It was just weird. I was looking it up.
Next to Dolph Lundgren's...
Get a Wikipedia, release date, and I had thing out, and then she's like, Poland.
That's not a good sign.
Dolph Lundgren.
Vipers.
There's like four muscular chicks coming out with towels to wipe him down.
Well, that's a spirit soldier. Okay. Coming to America release.
The little tab... Table of stuff 5th on the right.
5th of March, 2021.
Does it say anything about the country?
Yeah.
It says Poland, doesn't it?
The initial release was meant to be 17th of December, 2020.
Yeah.
In Russia.
Russia.
What?
Yeah. Yeah, man. It's actually coming out.
Did you see that one of his... Is it Dolomite?
Oh, yeah.
Was that any good?
Dolomite.
It was all right.
We won accolades for that.
Oh, did
it? It was up to critical...
I haven't seen it. I've got it to watch.
I went in really skeptical. I was like, this is going to be shit.
I mean, you would. The guy hasn't made a movie in the last 20 years.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Yeah?
Are you excited about coming to America? I'm not.
I'm staying positive.
I mean, I'm excited because it's Eddie Murphy, but
I tried to stay positive about Dumb and Dumber 2.
Oh, that wasn't good?
I walked out of that in 7 minutes.
Really?
I feel like Eddie Murphy's got enough class to not...
Rehash the same jokes.
Yeah.
I mean, if they're rehashing the same jokes, what was the point of making it?
Well, there's no need. Like, the whole cast is back. Like, the barbershop's still there.
Yeah, but if they... Yeah, that's true. Yeah,
but those old guys were, like, old in the early 90s.
Yeah.
20, 30 years later, what are they going to be? Still alive. Like, it's impossible. We're still cutting hair.
I don't know.
It's the same crew. Like, it's exactly the same crew in the
I don't know the story, so I'm not sure.
Okay, well, that's also the key thing as to why I'm not... Not,
the story
like, is this just a rehashed version, or is that a completely new?
The story is that his old man's on his deathbed or whatever.
Yeah,
and I know that Madge Sinclair, the woman that played the Queen, she passed away years ago.
Okay,
you know that they were the King and Queen in Lion King as well.
Yeah, he's amazing, man. He's a lot of voices.
In Lion King, animated.
Yeah, but like as in Madge Sinclair, the queen from Zamunda.
Oh, no, I didn't know that.
Really? Also,
I didn't know that.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's...
Anyway, the story is that on his deathbed, tells Prince Akeem that he has a son. Mm. He has a long-lost son.
Yeah.
So he's going to go back to America to find him. My big problem is... Okay. Tie in for a sequel? Perfect.
Right? Yeah.
Best way to do it. Yeah, cool. Fair enough. My big thing is... It goes against Prince Akeem's character completely.
Yeah,
the guy was a fucking Boy Scout in the first one. A Boy Scout. If it was Semi that had a son, it makes sense.
Yeah.
You know? But he was a Boy Scout. As soon as they got to America, he fell in love.
Yeah.
And then he spent the rest of the movie trying to chase this bird to marry. There's no way he would have fathered some random
kid. They did the one scene of them at the club. And then the next scene of that was...
And I'm the best.
And then probably the church. The church scene, and that was it.
I'm into the group thing. I was Joan of Arc in my former life.
That's probably my favorite scene of the whole movie.
She pulls a lighter out on a date. Dude, it's fucked. That movie's brilliant. Sorry, man, but like, I was thinking about, I remember once we were talking about the best movies ever. And we said, what movies are we going? Comedy? And you started naming some movies, and that's when you were talking about The Shawshank Redemption, all that sort of shit.
I still stand by my decision, as well as The Count of Monte Cristo.
I know. And my first thing was, dude, I actually laughed about it today.
Yeah.
I thought of a scene from Naked Gun 2. You know, he was in the bar, and he's just drinking, like, to get over his depression or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then George Kennedy. George Kennedy was underrated. Like, George Kennedy was... almost like as good as Frank Drebin, like as in them pairing up.
Yeah.
His reactions off screen were just, on screen were just incredible. But I just thought of like when we were having that argument and Andy challenged me straight off. I was like, what would you say? And I just went, Naked Gun. And I said, Hot Shots.
Yeah.
And you just started laughing.
Yeah.
You lost it. When I think of like the best movies, I literally think of Coming to America, Naked Gun, and Hot Shots.
Yeah. I don't disagree at all.
You can't fault them. But then there was like Top Gun Part 2 as well. Mm. Did you guys see it?
No.
Top Gun, no. But is that out?
Yeah.
It's come and gone, or is it still out?
I thought it kind of went.
I thought it hadn't even come out yet.
I didn't know it came out either.
Hang on, Top Gun 2.
Well, the thing is, nothing's coming to cinema. It's all going straight to
streaming. Yeah, you actually have to actively look for things now.
Yeah. Oh, no, it actually hasn't come out yet. 1st July, 2021.
Oh, okay.
Pete Maverick Mitchell keeps pushing the envelope after years of service as one of the Navy's top aviators. He must soon confront the past while training a new squad of graduates for a dangerous mission that demands the ultimate sacrifice.
He's going to die at the end, I guarantee it.
Nah.
It's the ultimate sacrifice. It's there in the blurb.
It'll look like he's dead, then he'll come back for part 3.
Dude,
how many Mission Impossibles have they made?
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
They keep squeezing out these franchises. Dude, Sniper, you know, with Tom Berenger?
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you seen the first one? With Billy Zane.
Years ago, yeah.
Yeah. I recently rewatched that. Bro, I love that movie.
Mm.
Yeah? It's sick. I rewatched it. And I always knew they made a second one, but I never saw it.
Is that the one with Mark Wahlberg?
No, that's the Shooter.
Oh, Shooter.
That's Shooter, yeah.
I watched Shooter.
They turned that into a TV show too, I think.
Yeah, they did.
I watched Shooter. Shooter was a good movie.
Yeah, I've seen it. Yeah, it was good, yeah.
Because then we watched American Sniper as well, remember?
Yeah, that's right.
So, Sniper was one of my favorite movies. It's not favorite movies, but it's a really good movie. I love Tom Berenger. He's one of my favorite actors. So, then I knew there was a part two, but I never watched it, right? Yeah. So, I kind of downloaded it, and it actually got released like in 2002, three, so like years after the first one, totally shit budget, totally shit script.
Yep.
It was crap, man.
Yep.
Like I fell asleep. Like I didn't stay up to watch it. Then I realized they actually made like four more.
Oh, really?
I think he's like Tom Berenger's just not in one of them. Dude, in Sniper 1, he loses his trigger finger. He has it cut off. Somehow they made five more with him.
You got another three digits.
I've never heard of that.
He can lose it for another three movies.
It's just every movie they keep taking.
They're just, I got a thumb. I'm left-handed.
He's using his feet.
My left foot.
No, but seriously. Dude, they are just squeezing the absolute life.
I don't think anyone has any ideas right now for any...
No.
I haven't seen any originals.
You would think COVID would create... ideas.
All it's done is put documentaries on Netflix for Outbreak, Black Plague, Pesticides.
I mean, it was just now as we came into 2021, they were saying that there was a whole bunch of like intellectual property that's now becoming available to the public domain.
Like what?
Oh, just
hang on, wait. Let me just Google.
Like
this.
They're famous, like novels or characters. Where did you hear this? I've heard about it like a year or two ago, and they kept saying it's coming up, because whichever companies owned it kept paying it for the domain to keep going. It's been like 100 years that these things haven't been open to the public to remake. And like they're saying, I think like Great Gatsby, I think.
Wait, Leo made that last one, didn't he?
I don't know which. I don't know how it works. Like maybe the company that made it is their parent company owns.
Yeah, it all depends, man. Basically, like with audio. The rule of thumb is something like 50 years.
Well, this has been like 100.
Dead, you know, 25 years after the initial recording. It all depends on who's paying for the license.
Well, this was like Disney characters and because...
So what, they're just remaking movies?
Yeah, but now it can be made with other people's versions.
Do you know what I'd like to see? I'd like to see a new Blade.
Okay.
From scratch, as in total reboot?
Just a total whole new thing, you know.
I'm just sad that...
It was way better than like a... Underworld, you know.
Underworld?
Yeah.
Underworld was like the wimpy version of Blade.
That's what I mean.
I've never seen any Blade of them, so...
You haven't seen Blade?
No.
Oh. Dude.
Goodbye, everyone.
I don't remember Blades, but I remember watching the first one and being like, Jesus God.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, it's just ruthless, man. It's Wesley Snipes.
Absolutely ruthless.
Just vampire slayer, man.
Yeah. Okay. Like splitting shit in half. Like brutal. It's just brutal. I loved it. Absolutely brutal.
No, I've never. I don't know. I'll check it out.
Yeah. The first one. And then they made the one with Ryan Reynolds.
I didn't watch that.
Yeah. Underworld was just. It was just. Yeah, weak.
They just. Mm. They're not getting adventurous with movies anymore.
No.
They've found the.
Marvel?
The moneymaker. I mean, people are making other movies, but they're not.
How often do you watch a movie on Netflix?
Hardly ever. I've got a massive list and I'll be never honest, watch
through
them.
COVID, I did watch it a bunch.
Mm. New or old, though?
Both.
Oh, both. Okay.
Yeah. I actively pushed to find new movies, even with unknowns, that like actors I'd never recognized.
Yeah.
So many of them, I'd switched off within 15 minutes.
Yeah, they're all trash. Yeah,
dude, trash.
Yeah.
Trash. Nothing memorable. Nothing.
Yeah.
I mean, the movies of the 90s and 2000s, even the 80s, like you had the big blockbusters, but they were still trash, but it had character to it. You could watch it. You remember all those cheap ass, like nasty martial arts movies from the 80s? It was like G.I. American or whatever. And it was they're like knockoffs of Chuck Norris.
Yeah.
You know?
It'd be, what's his name? Eric Roberts.
Yeah. It's just like, you know,
American kickboxer.
yeah. Stuff like that. Like there was character to it. They were crap, but they probably had a cult following, stuff like that. That stuff doesn't exist now because now it's so easy to probably make movies.
Well, that's the thing. I was going to say, now it's like back then, a studio would have to put up 50 mil.
Mm.
A movie would take a year and a half.
Mm.
And it would be like, say, Stallone's only movie in a year and a half.
Yeah.
Now, thanks to cheap cameras, production studios, like Netflix is a production company. Amazon's a production company.
Mm.
Google, like all these companies are now production houses. So just banging these movies out.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, screw it. With script. We don't need a script. Just throw them in front of the camera.
Yeah.
This angle, this lighting, done. And it's the same predictable crap over and over and over again.
And just Netflix as well. Then they go off your algorithm and they'll target you with more of that stuff.
Yeah.
So they're not letting you see other things that you might be interested
in. That's the one thing I hate about Netflix. You just can't get a good grasp of
just
every
show
title.
Me everything and I'll figure out what I want myself. Yeah.
My mate in Adelaide said to me like months ago, him and his missus were going through a list of like the top 100 movies that you have to see before you die.
Mm. Yeah.
Mm.
And it's like unbiased, like a general.
Shawshank's number one, isn't it? I bet you it's number one.
I bet you Count of Monte Cristo's 99.
I bet you it's not in the.
It's in the top 100.
How about we just look at this list?
I guarantee it.
I while you're doing that, Netflix were making Legend of Zelda.
I heard about that.
Did you hear what they just did?
No, here we go. What, they cast Tom Cruise as Link?
They cancelled it, even though they had started production, because people leaked it online and ruined the surprise. And they said, you know what?
What was the whole surprise? Thing's
cancelled. They're making it. They hadn't announced that they were making Legend of Zelda.
Okay.
Someone went online and said, oh, the next, I've got information, Netflix is leaking, making it. Netflix come out and they're like, nah. Not anymore.
Not anymore.
Not
just
anymore.
Like that. But I mean, they can do it. Look at that Marco Polo. Was it Marco Polo?
Yeah.
That show. I actually quite liked that. The first season was really, really good. second season started, and then it just became like a forest type, like a Hercules type thing. They're just always in a forest for some reason. You know, they probably ran low on budget,
yeah,
and like they cancelled after the second season.
Yeah.
Second season was crap.
Lord of the Rings, you know? And... Well, that shit. Just them walking in the forest.
No, no, no.
Hey, whoa, 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 whoa.
No, 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 no.
Hey,
hey, hey,
hey. Hey, whoa, whoa, hey, whoa, whoa,
hey. Hey, oh, hey, oh, oh, oh. Oh, where's that coming from? Oh, hey, oh, oh. Dude, come on.
That's what it is.
That's
oh,
a, oh, oh. That's a shot across the bow if I ever heard one.
Sorry,
wasn't that a Simpsons episode where Homer has to do that to zoom in and out with the... With the hidden camera for the mafia.
Hey! Oh!
I don't remember it. And he's like, you got an A to zoom out and O to zoom in. And he's like,
oh!
And then he's like, I'm walking over here. And then he's like, no, that's a self-destruct. And his hair just goes on fire.
Dude, look, Lord of the Rings... I think I fell asleep watching the first one in the movies.
You make me sick.
Yeah, I don't know if I can look at you the same way ever again.
I didn't... Can you let me finish?
I don't know, can we?
I don't know. You didn't let the Lord of the Rings finish.
You don't let me defend Count of Monte Cristo.
I was on your side for a bit. And now
I'm out of here. No. Look, I've watched Lord of the Rings.
One, two, and three?
Yes.
And the Hobbits? Okay.
Oh, Hobbits doesn't count.
The Hobbits don't count.
Oh, okay.
I've watched 1, 2, and 3. I think I remember maybe 2 minutes out of the three movies.
You weren't watching it.
I remember them walking a lot in a forest and then fighting random ghouls and then eventually throwing a ring in a volcano.
It is a quest. Of course they're going to be walking. They're not going to be in a Prius driving there. What do you think they're going to do?
Do you know what? Prius, they'd be the one dickhead to call you to go on a quest. But then when, like, he pulls you out of bed, like, yeah, we're doing this. And then you, like, get ready. You try calling him, doesn't answer. Like, his phone's actually switched off. It's like, yeah, sorry, man, I was asleep. You know what I mean?
I mean, technically, everything's a quest. You know, I went and got the coffee. That's a quest. Then you're done.
Is it a quest or a mission?
When I think of quests, I think of, like...
Quest is a mission. It's the same thing.
I think of a dude on a horse with a sword and, like, a naked woman, like, in a tower.
Well, that's like an old possible as well.
Wizard, you know, with, like...
Yeah, that's possible. There's a wizard there. There was a barbarian there.
There's got to be
Did you hear about? I think it's HBO. They're making they're remaking. They're making a Lord of the Rings. Did you hear about that?
The game?
No. TV show. Like,
oh,
Witcher.
Yeah. I heard about that too.
And people, I don't know if people are cracking it, but they're like, oh, it's going to be like a not Witcher. It's going to be like a basically, you know, like
Game of Thrones.
Yeah, like a Game of Thrones is going to be all...
You know what I always think of?
I know they're making a game along with...
There's going to be a lot of TNA and a lot of Nookie and stuff like that.
TNA?
Like, yeah, tits and ass.
And I'm like, to hear it, that's all.
Okay. Well, like, it's an all-male cast. Who's banging who? Like, you know, like...
I don't think...
Unless Jim Lee and...
They shouldn't do that. Legolas.
Yeah. Legolas. We get some closure on that relationship.
I don't think they should do that to Lord of the Rings. I really don't.
No, I don't think so either. I mean, it'd be good for a TV show.
No, I wouldn't like it.
You wouldn't like it either?
I can't stand Game of Thrones for that. Like, every time there's a sex scene, I just skip it.
Why? Like, I think it'd be good done as if it was given the TV show treatment, but obviously not
Yeah. It would be a great TV show.
Because you can lengthen it, get more scenes and all that.
Like,
you know?
just give me a little subtitle, a sex scene, and skip to the next scene. Yeah. All right, done. I'm happy with that. I know they just had sex.
Yeah.
I don't need to see some dude groaning.
You need that 80s transition where, like, they're in a...
Oh, that pan
that with the shuttered windows, and then it's like, the sax music starts, fade to black, and then pops back up.
Yeah, pops
she's
back
on the
up.
Bed under the covers. He's upright. His chest is exposed.
He's having a
fades
dirty.
Again. Dude, every time I think of the word quest, I just think of that episode with Homer. How he tries to sue the all you can eat seafood joint.
Oh yeah,
and Marge's like, can you just leave it alone? No, Marge, this is my quest. Don Quixote.
Like I said, everything's technically a quest.
No, it's
going to the shops, going to the toilet, going to the fridge.
Quest Impossible.
Quest Impossible. Hey, there you go. There's an idea.
That's an original.
Hey. The Mission Impossible song. Mission Impossible song played on a lute.
You know, if I get on YouTube, it probably is.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
Look it up.
I'm sure. I'm sure there is. I think the last thing I watched on Netflix, besides Trailer Park Boys, which is a daily thing, is Castlevania.
Okay.
That's the only other thing I've watched.
Is that good? I haven't watched it.
Very good.
Yeah.
Okay. Very good.
Last thing, I haven't watched anything on there for ages, but the last...
That's not a lute, though.
Yeah, that's not a lute.
Well, it's an acoustic guitar.
But don't they make different noises? A lute and a guitar.
Yeah, acoustic? I would have thought so. I can play this.
Calm down.
Amateur.
Can you play guitar?
No, and I never want to.
Okay.